Exhale, wrap them around the leg loops and dive in for a child's pose. So you can rest your head on the nape of your hands. Feet can just gently fall one over the other. And now you're going to pull the energy towards center. You're looking towards your navel. And lift it back down. This is another place to come and hang out if you ever need a break. Now we're going to inhale and blossom for star. So legs expand. There we go. Arms expand. Hips stay heavy. And then exhale, sit back down, coming to child. We're going to do that three times. Undulating the spine. Inhale, expand. Step. Really good. And exhale, squeeze. Round in, child. Beautiful. One more time. Inhale, expand. Exhale, drop the hips. Come back to the T arms. Come back to neutral. Alright, so that's just half of the flow. So let's start adding on to it. I'm going to show you what it looks like so you can get the details, and then we're going to do it together. So from star, we're going to straighten the legs, straighten the hands, bend the elbows, and then lean back for reverse namaste. I'm going to give you the stretch so you can see it a little bit better. And we'll all practice. Do you have the arrow?
It's like you don't have to talk to me anymore.
No.
I hear you.
Okay.
That's funny. It went up to. You too. I think that'll be good. Let's try that. Okay. So just watch the demo and then we'll do it together. We'll put it all together. It's just nice to know that how to transition from one to the other so it goes smoothly.
We squeeze the legs together. Hands together, elbows bent, so we're locking, so it's not like this, right? The forearms are locking. That's our anchor. When we press the hips up, we come into a reverse namaste. Then I hold on to the swing. I lean back, so my head's pointing down towards the ground. I just shimmy a little bit, so it's right along the top of the iliac crest along the hips. And then this is called ladle. Hands come down. And then if you want to go a little bit further, bend the knees and swim back. This is flow. From bow, we hold on, going a little bit faster than I normally would. And then you lift your head and sink the hips. So it's a pivot point in the body. Okay, so let's try that together. Let's inhale to the arms. Exhale, child. So round in. So let yourself bow towards your navel. Inhale, expand and blossom into star. So keep the hips heavy, heart open, beautiful guys. And then squeeze the legs together, squeeze the hands together, bend the elbows and hold on with the forearms and press the hips up. That's awesome. Good job. All right, reverse namaste. Take a breath here. Really feel how much this is opening up the front of the spine. Now reach up and hold on to the swing. And then let your head drift down towards the ground. So just bring weight. Now leg loops are slow at the knees, so just bring weight into the upper body and then the lower body, staying engaged. Now make sure the swing is in the sweet spot so you can release your hands. You can stay holding on if you want, but if you want to bring your palms up, so straight arms, palms up, just feel like a ladle. Feel like gravy at Thanksgiving. There you go.
Don't say gravy.
All right, bend the knees if you want to go a little further. Make sure the back is happy. Reach back. Hold on to the ankles. Yeah, the swing has got you. A little bit of trust, right? A lot of trust. Okay. So we're in a supported bow. Open the heart. Make sure, so the swing is great because it allows the lower spine to stay expanded. So we can really start to initiate. So press your heart towards the front door. And you can press your hand, legs back. Oh, ankles into your hands. If you want to go to full extent. Now this is a big stretch, so we're going to inhale, release the ankles, reach up for the swing. Right? Lift the head, lower the hips, nice and slow. Amazing, right? Such a big back bend. How'd that feel?
Good.
Yeah.
So if this part of the body can stay really open, then this part of the body can really start to initiate the pose. If anytime you feel pressure in your lower back, just pause, don't go any further, which means it might look like this, right? And you don't have to grab or extend. Just make sure that you open up the back slowly so this part stays happy.
good?
I'm here.
Awesome. So we'll do it two more times. Nice and slow. Inhale, open. Exhale, child's pose. Inhale, open for star. Expand. Exhale, squeeze together. Reverse namaste, right? Hook with your elbows. Inhale, open. Just press the hips up. Exhale, hold on to the swing and then lower down. Inhale, open, right? Extend the spine. Arms can swim down. Ladle. Exhale, just relax into it. This might be as far as you go. So if you want to bend your knees, inhale, swim your arms back. Exhale. See if you can reach forward with the heart. And then exhale, relax into it. So can we get that nice pulse with the breath where we're inhaling and still opening, and then exhaling, we're not closing, but we're relaxing into it. And then release the ankles. Inhale, reach up for the swing. Exhale, sit back down. Now, nice and slow, because you get a free high on the way up. It's all the blood rushing to your brain, making you smarter, prettier, happier, funnier. At least you think so when you're in the swing. Really good, guys. Okay, so let's add on to that sequence. So that's half of the floor. So the other half is coming through a skydiver, and there's a lot of different positions that we can do here. So let's get into, I'm going to show you the easy version first. That's our style today. Take the leg loop and spread it from your knee to your groin, upper thigh.
Are we doing it too?
Yep. Yeah. Okay. So you just push your hips up and then slide it in. So from the knee to the upper thigh. Yeah. Now that you're not going to drop your hips, right? This is pushing them up. So keep your hips up, then they won't slide down. So pull them up and then keep your hips up. Yeah. Okay. Reach for the outer edge of this of the leg loop again. You got it. You can do both if you want. And then just pull yourself up to sit. Oh, that's so much easier.
When we do it the other way, you'll understand. Okay, just bend your knees so your feet come towards one another. So this is what's going to happen. We always keep our arms around the swing, but they're going to thread in front of the leg loops. Yeah, really good, guys. And then we lean forward with the heart and the hips, and we come into people not skydiver. Bottoms of the feet can come together if you want to keep pressing forward. Really good. Now we're opening up the whole front of the spine. This is a big one. Bend your elbows. Now you can drop your head in your heart and high. This is flying butterfly. So those were the easy breezy steps. So it's okay to be in high diver, Priya, that's great. You can keep the leg loops there and just bring your arms forward. Yep. Can you bring your arms in front of the leg loops? Keep your arms around the swing. All right, so to come out of this, even though it feels really good, let's reverse it. We're going to bring our feet down towards the ground. Press, 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 press. And then lift. Lean back and relax. So see if you can try that one more time. It can help create for a minute. You guys stay there. So see if you can get into it. So just remember to wrap, keep your arms wrapped around the swing. And then they come in front of the legs. Easiest way is to extend the leg loops the whole way. I know, it'll feel better later. we're done. It's like myofascial release during massage. It's a free massage. So we're going to come into our high diver the same way. So we keep our arms around the swing at all times, right? But then we come to prayer and then thread them in front. Yeah. And then we press forward. Yeah, you got it. Nice, Priya. So we lift our feet. So this is our little high diver. We're going to make sure they're kind of on the outside of the hip creases. We like the plunk. There you go. Feels good, huh? It's really very therapeutic for the hips, especially when they get tight. Okay. And then we bend the elbows, bend the knees, and then we hang. So that little rotation that happens there is actually opening up all the fascia, all the stickiness in the hips. So now the underarms aren't complaining so much, right? The hips are like, ah! Okay, good. So we're going to come into our down dog from here. We haven't done any of the forward fold sequences yet. So, feet come down. You keep your upper body where it is, so you can land it. One arm at a time, straighten, and then bring your fingertips to the floor, and then straighten and bring your fingertips to the floor. Good. So we're in a down dog, right? A little wide straddle down dog. Don't try to squeeze your legs together. Beautiful. But press your hips back a lot. So you're going to be shaking the body. Shake your head out. Just relax here for a breath. We're going to come into our floating leaf in a minute. But just notice this is like your favorite assistant, spiraling the energy around the legs and pulling up through the sit bones in your down dog, right? Something to do this against the wall with the ropes. Very intimate pose. All right, so we're going to bend our elbows and we let our upper body hang. Just let your feet drift up. Don't let them float higher than the hips, but you can let your feet swagger from side to side and up. There you go. So this gentle rocking motion is going to open up all that connective tissue in there. You might feel one hip is a little bit more sticky than the other. Just take note of how they're feeling. Really good, guys. It's not amazing. It is intense, but it's incredibly good at healing lower back pain and working with hip joint pain, since it's opening up that part that never gets access. So it's like the dormant part. The intertrochanteric area is also where the psoas connects, and the psoas is another muscle that is a culprit for lower back pain. Beautiful, guys. Okay, so we're just going to play a little bit. We're going to inhale and pull ourselves forward. Wide, exhale, press back. Inhale, pull forward. Nice, like we're doing handstand arms, arch. Exhale, press back. That looks good, guys. So, Priya, if you bring your feet down towards the ground, or you won't fall out. There you go, perfect. Inhale, pull forward. Exhale, press back. And this time, we're going to pull forward and land it. See if you can use your momentum to come up. You're going to get a little bit of up. If you see stars, you're in the right place. Wow.
Yeah.
Everybody's sorry. Thank God we had our harness on.
Thank God.
All right. So get the swing behind your back. There you go. You're welcome. Sorry. Wow.
I got it.
That was so fun. Awesome. So we isolate our, identify your leg loops, isolate them, press them forward, lift your knees, and then you come back in. Totally good. Woo! Right? Magic. We run, well, right back where we were again. All right, let's chill here for a few. You guys are doing really great. So we are going to do one more round of lounging into Dancing Cheetah. And then we're going to come back through some, we pretty much skipped our warm-up lap, so we're going to do some grounding poses and then some forward fold.